worship the Almighty God. Open your mouth and begin to appreciate Him. Open your mouth, begin to thank Him. What a mighty God we serve. Appreciate the King of Kings. Appreciate Jesus. If you know He has kept you to be alive, Jesus, we love you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus, we love you.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you.
You are mighty.
situation. When she saw the blood all over the bed, she was wondering, but I'm not in my menses. Then she went to check the growth on the inside. Ladies and gentlemen,
hallelujah.
The Almighty God had removed the growth.
Amen.
Jesus Christ of Nazareth had removed
the
growth.
Thank you, Jesus.
Can you lift up your hands to heaven? Let's worship
this
God.
Thank you, Jesus.
What more can we say to this God?
Father, we thank you.
What more can we say to this God?
Thank you, Jesus.
Lift up your hands. So we worship you.
Worship you, all night
to him. My God.
Mighty man in virtue.
I trust in you.
You are the God of angels. My trust is in you. You are the miracle walking God.
My trust is in you.
Thank you, Lord.
22 from verse 15 very quickly. Isaiah 32, we'll read from verse 15 all through to verse 18. Church, can we read it together? We'll do it simultaneously. I will do verse 15, you will do 16, I will do 17, and you will do 18, or we'll take 18 together. Hallelujah. Do you have a Bible in your hands? Do you have a Bible? All right, open to Isaiah. I've often told you before, anybody that have eye problem, just be reading only the book of Isaiah, your eyes will open. Hallelujah. If you want children, don't read any other book, just read the book of Numbers. Before you get to Numbers of chapter 10, before you read chapter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, twins don't come. The book of Numbers carry children. If enemies won't let you rest, fighting you day and night, just read the book of Deuteronomy, your enemy. Deuteronomy. That one, as you are reading it, they are dying naturally. This is wisdom. Amen. I said amen. If you want to be great, just read the books of Apostle Paul. You want to be great? Start reading from Acts. Romans, Corinthians, to Ephesians, to Colossians. Before you finish, greatness will hit you by force. These are wisdom. Amen. Your life is changing today. Isaiah chapter 32, verse 15, the Bible says, until the Spirit be poured upon me from on high. I didn't say us, because I know it's only me that will get it today. How many of you will get it? How many of you will get it? Until the Spirit be poured upon us from on high, the wilderness be a fruitful field, and the fruitful field be counted for a forest. Verse 16. Verse 17. And the work of righteousness shall be peace. And the effect of righteousness is quietness and assurance forever. Verse 18, everybody want to go. And in a quiet resting place. Hallelujah. Very quickly this morning, I'd like to do a teaching I titled Assessing Durable Peace. Assessing durable peace. Durable. Peace that is durable. Peace that is continual. Peace that cannot be stopped. Accessing durable peace. Durable. 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 I like to start by saying that the God we serve is a God of peace. Jeremiah 29 verse 11. See, I know the thought that I think towards you. They are thought of peace and not of evil. God is a God of peace. Psalms 85 and verse 8. Bible said, the Lord shall speak peace. God shall speak peace. The Almighty that we serve is a God of peace. Isaiah 52 verse 7. Isaiah 52 7. The Bible said the word of God is peace, and God is his word. God is his word. In Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6 and 7. The Bible says Jesus Christ is the Prince of Peace, and his government is the government of peace. His government is the government of peace. If you read the scripture that we just read now, the Bible says, until the Spirit of God be poured upon them from on high, the wilderness now is counted for a fruitful field, and the fruitful field will become a forest. Then judgment will be in the wilderness. When judgment come upon the wilderness in their dwelling places, then verse 17, the people will now begin to enjoy peace. So there are conditions to accessing peace. There are conditions through which you can access peace. But ladies and gentlemen, what is peace? In this first service, what is peace? What is peace? Peace simply means freedom from violence or commotion. Freedom from violence. When you are free from violence, when you are free from commotion, from trouble, then you have peace. Peace is freedom from commotion or violence. Or violence. The Bible says in Job chapter 34, verse 29. Job 34, 29. The Bible says, if God, he said, when God gives quietness, who can give trouble? When God gives quietness, who can give trouble? When he hideth his face, who then cannot behold him? Whether it be done against a nation or against a man only. When God gives quietness, who can give trouble? When God deliver you from trouble and bring you into peace, who can give it? Peace is freedom. The Bible says, and Solomon had rest round about, free from peace. I don't know what is troubling you. In the name that is above every other name, my God will give you peace today. I say, my God, whom I serve, will give you peace today. In Proverbs 16 and verse 7, Proverbs 16 and verse 7, the Bible was very clear. It said, when a man's way pleases the Lord, instead of enemies troubling him, he maketh his enemies to be at peace. In other words, he maketh him to be free from commotion. He maketh you to be free from trouble. Peace is to be free from trouble. When they say this man is a man of peace, he's a man that is free from commotion, free from violence. Free from violence. What is peace? Peace is a state, I like this one, it's a state of mutual harmony. Calabasate. Peace is a state of mutual harmony between people or groups. Mutual. The emphasis here is the word mutual. In other words, peace is a decision that people must take. And we go there very far later in the day. It's a mutual harmony. In other words, you agree and I agree that we should live in peace. It's mutual. It's a state of mutual harmony, mutual rest, mutual freedom from everything that will cause you trouble. Mutual. When I was checking my Bible, I discovered that Solomon, the king of Israel in his time, had a mutual agreement with the king of Tyre. His name is called King Hiram. That they should live in peace, and they gave a terms on how they should go about it. Mutual harmony. Mutual. No wonder peace cannot be everywhere, because not everybody agreed to live in peace. Am I speaking to somebody here? Not everybody will agree to live in peace. Look at what David said in the book of Psalms 120, verse 6 and 7. Psalms 120, verse 6 and 7. David said very clearly there, put it on the board. He said, look, he said, my soul long dwelleth among people that hate peace. My soul is dwelling among people that hate peace. They hate peace. These are haters of peace. In verse 7, he said, even if I speak peace, they speak war. Can you see that? He said, even if I speak peace, this kind of people, they speak war. It's not everybody that want to live with you in peace. There are people that don't like peace. They are called the haters of peace. They don't want anything called peace. If you live around them, you must suffer trouble. But let me announce to you, when a man's way pleases the Lord, he maketh even his enemies to be at peace with you. And everyone that will not be at peace with you, God will take them away from you in the name of Jesus. Jesus came as the Prince of Peace. Two of us. Jesus came as what? Prince of Peace. But in Luke 19:27, even as the Prince of Peace, there were people that would not let him rest. Jesus, as the Prince of Peace, there are people that will not let him rest. Look at what Jesus said in Luke 19:27. He said, there are enemies that will not let me rest. Even no matter how I try to bring peace, all they are fomenting is trouble. Anything I do, they are fomenting trouble. Therefore, this particular day, go and bring that kind of enemies, that they might be what? They might be slain. Can I prophesy? I say, can I prophesy? Every man, woman, anyone, anywhere in the world who are beating his or her chest that they will trouble you, that you will never have peace, that they will never give you peace in your life, from today, my God will avenge for you in their camp.
Amen.
I said, today, my God will give you peace from them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And if they won't let you go, they shall go for your sake. You know what? Jeremiah 28:9. Jeremiah 28:9. The Bible says, prophesy peace. Do what? Do what? What did God say we should do? We should prophesy peace. Jeremiah 28:9. Studio. Any Bible I quote, give me the Bible, please. He said, the prophet which prophesieth of peace. There are peace prophets like Jesus. Jesus was a prophet and he was a peacemaker. Not just because he was a peacemaker, himself he was peace. But yet, people won't let him rest. Yet, men won't let him rest. Can I say something to you? Isaiah 48:22. Isaiah 48:22. The Bible said, there is no peace, says the Lord, unto the wicked. There is no peace, says the Lord, unto the wicked. That is why I am prophesying now, that anyone that have vowed that you will not have peace, that person's peace is ceased forever in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I thought your amen would be the loudest.
Amen.
I think I was studying my Bible somewhere some time ago. I think it's Matthew 10:34-35. Give me that scripture. Let me check something there. Yeah, the Bible says something. Jesus said, I have not come for peace again. I came for sword. Matthew 10. That's it. 34. Matthew 10:34. Jesus said, think not that I am come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but to send this word. Why did he make that statement? There are people that will not let him rest. There are people that have vowed, the scribes, the Pharisees, the evil people, that they must trouble him. He said, look, I will give them sword. Can I prophesy? Can I prophesy? One of the reasons why you don't have peace is because there are people that have vowed that you will not have peace. In your office, they are troubling you. Where you live in your house, no matter how you try to bring peace, they are there troubling you, monitoring you in one way or the other to ensure that you have trouble. Let me prophesy to you today. The sword of God from heaven will reply them for you.
Amen.
To give peace. Peace is a mutual harmony. It's a mutual togetherness. It's a mutual concession. To be happy, to be at rest, to be in emotional freeness. No, not to be stressed again. That is what peace is all about. But there are people that have vowed that you must not have peace. Let me tell you, before I go further, let me tell you the dangers of not having peace. Quickly. Dangers. When there is no peace, number one, what you lose your health. Anytime there is no peace, you lose your health. Every man that lacks peace is a sick man. Can I preach? In case you don't know, ladies and gentlemen, Many of the causes, or the major cause of high blood pressure and diabetes, is lack of peace. Where I'm going next will surprise you. Major cause of lack of peace is sickness. If you see a place where there is no peace, sickness reigns there. You know why? Because God is absent. Anywhere there is no peace, there is no God. When God abstains from the place, peace eludes that place, and then the next thing that happens there is trouble. Sickness. Sickness. That's why the Bible says, mountain will pour peace upon the people. Number two, when there is no peace, what you have there is crisis. Between a husband and a wife, where there is no peace, every day is trouble. Blow, insult, all manner of things. Where there is no peace, there is chaos, crisis. Where there is no peace, there is poverty. Lack of peace is one of the major causes of poverty. Because peace brings what we call instability. It makes you to lose focus. A man who does not have peace has no focus. And when you have no focus, you can't become anything in life. Poverty reigns. You see why peace is important. Number three or four. When there is no peace, you can't make heaven. When there is no peace, there is no relationship with God that can guarantee you making heaven. You see why peace is very important. Peace is everything God spoke about. Lack of peace is everything the devil brought into this world. Lack of peace is everything the devil brought. But hear me. Hear me. I don't know your state of peace before you came here this morning. But one thing is very sure. Before you leave here today, my God will give you peace in the name of Jesus. Jesus said to them in John 14 verse 1. He said, let your heart not be troubled. Isn't it? John 14 1. Let your heart not be troubled. John 14 27. The reason why he said let them not be troubled is because he said, I give you peace. When there is peace, there is no trouble. He said, let your heart not be troubled. Verse 27. He said, I give you peace. I give you peace. When peace is in place, trouble is absent. The presence of peace is the absence of trouble. The presence of peace is the presence of Christ. And the presence of Christ is the presence of victory. When there is peace, there must be victory. You see? John chapter 20 verse 21. Jesus said, take my peace. I give you peace. I give you peace. John 20, 21. I give you peace. Somebody is hearing me here today. By the authority in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you are living here with much peace in the name of Jesus. Let me continue by saying that we have about 7 levels of peace. 7 levels. What I call levels of peace. Levels. Somebody's level is about to change. I say your level is about to change. I don't know whether you have peace at all. Even if you have, God is about to change the levels of your peace. The Bible says there are levels of peace. The level of peace, number one, is the level of normal peace. This one, you just have it. Huh? You have peace. I'm about to say something. When I finish where I'm coming from, I'll say something. That's level one of peace is peace. It's what we call normal peace. Peace. That one, you have it. Proverbs 16:7. John 14:27. Peace. John 20:21. Peace. He gives you peace. Job 34 verse 29. Peace. But there is another level of peace. Level number two is the level of what we call great peace. Somebody say great peace. Psalms 119 and verse 165. Psalms 119 verse 165. Put it on the screen. He said, great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. You see? The people that are the level of great peace, anything you do trying to stop them, you are wasting your time. At that level, even the arrow you throw at them, they use it as pole to build their house. Nothing offend them. You try to send them away from church, you are wasting your time. They didn't come for your sake. They know who they are pursuing. They are looking for Jesus, not for you. So you can't do anything against their peace. Bible says nothing offends them. They have peace. No matter how you try to make them get angry, you see them laughing. And it's not a fake or pretentious or sarcastic laugh. It's a laugh they mean from the heart. Nothing offends them. These people are at the level of great peace. If you look at Isaiah 54 verse 13. Isaiah 54 verse 13. Put it on the screen. He said, instead of thorn. Isaiah 54 verse 13, please. He said, and all thy children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of thy children. Is that the prophecy for somebody here? Is that the prophecy for somebody here? Great shall be the peace of thy children. Your peace shall be great from today in the name of Jesus. Number three. This is another very dangerous level. This level of peace is the level we call level of abundant peace. Abundant, abundant, abundant. Psalms 37 verse 11. Psalms 37 verse 11. These ones, they have what we call abundance of peace. Abundance. But the meek shall inherit the earth and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. So these ones are for people who are humble. These are for meek people like Moses. Numbers chapter 12 verse 3. Moses was the meekest man on the planet Earth. Moses, the meekest man on the planet Earth. Matthew 11, verse 28 and 29. Jesus said, for I am gentle and meek. I am lowly. I am meek in my heart. So, this kind of peace, this abundance of peace, are for those people who are humble. You know why? They are almost at the level, heaven's level, on here on the earth. That's what they enjoy, because they are meek. And remember that when God was seeking for people, I was wondering who God was looking for. He said, I was looking for a meek man. Anytime God wants to give this kind of peace, he looks for people that are meek. Numbers 12 from verse 1 to 3 say, when I was looking for somebody that I will send, I didn't see anybody, but I saw Moses as the meekest. So I chose him and I gave him this abundance of peace. Ladies and gentlemen, the reason why Pharaoh could not stand before Moses was because of this peace. When you have this level of peace, any kind of battle, you are a winner. Am I speaking to somebody here? I decree, somebody from this service, you are entering this level in the name of Jesus. Number three, I love this one. Please write down the scripture, Psalm 72 verse 7. Abundance of peace. Now get this. Number three, perfect peace. Number three, we call it perfect peace. Psalm or Isaiah chapter 26 verse 3. Isaiah 26 verse 3. Isaiah 26. Thou will keep him in perfect peace. Let me start from verse 1, please. Isaiah 26 from verse 1. In that day shall this song be sung in the land of Judah. Shall this song be sung? Somebody is about to sing a new song. You are not saying a better amen today. I say your song is about to change. Put it on the screen. Put it there. In this day shall this song be sung in the land of Judah. We have a strong city. Salvation will God appoint for walls and bulwarks. Verse 2, quickly. verse 2. He said, open ye the gates that the righteous nation may keep the truth, may enter in, that keep the truth may enter in. Verse 3 now. The Lord shall keep them in perfect peace. This level of perfect peace, they are for righteous people. People who practice righteousness at the highest level. You see the reason why you are not enjoying lots of peace now. You see the reason why some level of peace, you miss it. You see somebody smiling just now, yeah, the next time you see his eyes like palm kernel. You see the person, the pain is not there. They are pretending, they are faking it. Do you know you can fake peace? But ladies and gentlemen, you can fake peace for people to see, but your body knows there is no peace. A man that have no peace inside AC, the sweat, pa, 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 pa. Put the AC 100%. The more the AC increase, the more the heat increase. A man who have no peace, AC brings heat. You put on AC, say, Kai, the heat is too much. You put off the AC, the person is dying. You put on AC, the person is dying. No place is comfortable. This level of perfect peace is for righteous people. It's for people who are what? Who are righteous. It's for righteous people. The righteous people, God will open the gate of perfect peace. He opens the gate for them of perfect peace. And what? He puts a song in their mouth. Anytime you see them, they are singing. Like unto thee, oh Lord. As you carry your problem, those who are complaining, you know, there are people who have the ministry of complaining and murmuring. Have you seen any of them before? I know some of them. Their ministry is ministry of complaining and murmuring. That's their ministry. Anytime you meet them, you have never met them and they share good news. You have never met them and they share testimony. Every day you meet them, something wrong is what they are saying. Their eyes are always seeing negative things. Their eyes and their ears are only ready for negative news. No wonder social media knows that people love negative news. That's why they put it there. Remember that negative news sells more than news, good news. When there is a good news, nobody will say anything. Hello? There are people who love negative news. But if you meet a man of perfect peace, as you are sharing the negative news, you see him smiling and celebrating God. The man is celebrating God. As you are sharing it and crying, shedding crocodile tears, the man is laughing. Because to him, all things are beautiful. It's only you that you are seeing trouble. We are seeing victory. Am I speaking to you here? Somebody is entering that level today. I don't like your amen at all. Number what now? Number 5. There is a level of peace that we call a flowing peace. Somebody say flowing peace. Kai. This is the peace, the river level of peace, my God. This is a mighty one. In Isaiah chapter 66 verse 12. Isaiah 66 verse 12. There is a level of peace that is a river peace. A wise man sang, he said, when peace is flowing like a river. Who knows that song? When peace is flowing like a river. There is a peace that flows at this river level. Look at how Isaiah put it. He said, for thus saith the Lord, behold, I will extend peace to her like a river. This type of peace never finish. Just like River Benue cannot dry, this level of peace can never finish. Even if the devil lie, let them throw arrows at you, your peace level is growing. Your peace level is increasing instead of it coming down. Ladies and gentlemen, what the devil is looking for is your peace. If the devil can get your peace, he can get your spirit. If he gets your spirit, he gets your life. That's why God increases this level of peace. so that no matter the arrow of the devil, your river of peace is increasing. The peace is increasing. And you hear people say things like, but we have tried to stop this man. Why is it that we can't stop him? Everything we do, he's still smiling. Jesus enjoyed that level. Everything they tried against him, you will see him smile and continue. And I never see anything. His level of peace was increasing. The river level was increasing. Ladies and gentlemen, when you hear river, the reason why River Benue cannot dry, or River Niger, let me tell you today. Look up. Look up. The reason why River Benue and River Niger cannot dry, hear it today, is because they have what we call tributaries. River Benue and River Niger have what we call tributaries. I will explain. Look up. Look up. I want to relate it to what we are talking about, peace. They have what we call tributaries. Tributaries simply means other smaller river flowing into them. Are you hearing me now? This is River Benue. What makes River Benue, River Benue, is because there are other smaller rivers flowing into them. Hello. So what River Benue does is that it doesn't dry, is that it collects water from other rivers. Sometimes for River Benue to become big, other rivers will dry. During dry season, you will discover that other rivers have dried up. There is no water in those rivers. And you start wondering, where did this water go? It is River Benue that collected the river. He collected all the waters that they have. What am I talking about? When you are at this level, you have the capacity to collect other people's level of peace. If they don't want peace, they come to you, you collect their own. When they come around you and they try to make you lose your peace, they try to make you miss God, they try to make you see God from a different perspective, and you are busy worshiping God, you are giving God thanks, the peace that they cannot hold, their own is flowing into your own. While your own is growing, they are dying. They are a tributary to your own peace. They are connected to your own peace. They are adding to your own peace. As they are crying, their peace is flowing onto you. Ladies and gentlemen, many of you have lost your peace. You have given it to somebody who has peace flowing like a river. That is why you have nothing to show. But I have come to speak to you today by the authority in the name of Jesus. Your peace shall return back today. So River Benue collects other rivers. They dry up. By February, March now, you go to other smaller rivers, you won't see anyone again. You'll be wondering, where did the waters go? They sank into the ground. No, sir. They flew into River Benue. He collected everything. So there are people who have peace like river. Their river of peace, or their level of peace, is growing because they are collecting other people's peace. When you come around them, they collect your peace. As you are crying, you are shedding tears, they are smiling, they are collecting your own. Their own level is increasing. Your own level is going down. You don't know what's happening. Anytime you complain, you donate your peace. If you complain, you donate your peace. You donate it to somebody else. You donate your peace. Somebody's level of peace is growing, your own is coming down. What can I prophesy? Can I prophesy? My God, in the name of Jesus, we give you the ocean level of peace. See how weak your amen is. Number six is the level of peace that we call the assured peace. Assured. It's a peace that you are sure of. You are sure. You know it's there. It's an assured level. Assured peace. It's a peace you know. You are sure it is there. Jeremiah 14 and verse 13. Jeremiah 13, 14 and verse 13. Put it on the screen. This level is a level of peace that you are sure many people are sure they have peace today? Their peace are threatened. The peace of the church is threatened. They are no longer sure. Do I still have it? Am I sure? Well, even if you know they, well. But there is a level of peace that you are sure. That is there. Look at what the Bible says. They put it on the screen. Then said I, Ah, Lord, behold, the prophet say unto them, ye shall not see this world, neither shall ye have famine, but I will give you assured peace in this place. Assured, in this land where you are about to enter, you will enjoy what we call assured peace. In other words, throughout your stay in this land, there shall be no trouble. Can I prophesy to 25 people here? In this service today, you will enter into the level of assured peace in the name of Jesus. Let me hear your amen loud and clear. And finally, on this level of peace is what I call level no peace. No peace. No peace. No peace. There are people that don't have peace at all. Isaiah 48 and verse 22. Isaiah 48, 22. Put it on the screen. The Bible says, there is no peace, saith the Lord, unto the wicked. This level is a level of what? No peace. They don't have it at all. A woman came to me and said to me, say, Pastor, since I married my husband, from the day we married, that was yesterday. I don't know if she's in church. Don't show yourself when you are there. She said to me, she said, Pastor, since I married my husband, it's 5 years now. There is no one day that we smile together. There is no one day. Every day is from one trouble fight to another. Every day, every day, every day. Pastor, please help me. Level of no peace. The Bible said something very clear. That's where I want to go now. The Bible said, even the way of peace they know not. There is a way of peace. The Bible said the way of peace they know not. Isaiah chapter 39 verse 8. Isaiah 39 and verse 8. The Bible said the way of peace they know not. Put it on the board, these boys. They know not the way of peace. You need to know Isaiah 39 verse 8. Isaiah 39 verse 8. The way of peace they don't even know. Or Isaiah 59, sorry, verse 8. Put it, Isaiah 59. Let me see verse 8 there. The way of peace. Look at it there. The way of peace they know not. And because they know not the way of peace, the devil showed them the way of trouble. I don't know who is having pain, problem in his family. I don't know who have never enjoyed peace before. After this service today, you will enjoy peace. If you say better amen, the miracles will come to you quickly. Now, let me reserve this other one for the second service. But let's take this. Isaiah 59 verse 8. We just read it now. The Bible said the way of peace, they know not. They know not the way of peace. Now, look at that scripture very carefully. It means peace has a way. There is a way to access peace. There is a way to access peace. So very quickly, that brings me to this other topic, subtopic. How to access peace. Write it down. How to access peace. There is a way of peace. There is a way of what? Of peace. So let's look at some of the ways through which one can get peace. This durable peace. Not momentary peace, not temporal peace. Let's see how to access peace, the way of peace. the way of peace. Jesus. Let's read the book of Psalms 34. If we have the time, we'll read from verse 12. Psalms 34 from verse 12. Put it on the screen. The Bible says, what man is he that desireth life and loveth many days, that he may see good? This is a question. How many of you want this one? Put it there. Put it there. Who is the man that wants good life? Want to live long? And want to see good things? Do we have anybody here that want that? Do we have anybody here? Then you need to be attentive. Because it started by a question. They say, who is the man that desireth life, not death? Who is the man that wants to live long, not premature death? And who is the man not just living long that you want to see good? There are people alive, but they are not seeing good. If you are alive and you don't have access to good, you will want to die. Life is frustrating without anything good happening. That's why people commit suicide. I believe God, during the second service, I will say some few things. The dangers of ingratitude. Who is that man? Let's go ahead. Go to verse 13 now. Look now. This is a question. The question is getting answered now. Go ahead. Verse 13. The Bible says, such a person must keep his or her tongue from evil and thy lips from speaking deceit. The word guile means deceit. If you want to see good days, you want to live long, you want to see good days, and you want to live a good life, the Bible says, carry, come out your mouth. Some people, their mouth are like basket. Everything they see, they talk. Put it on the board. Remove picture. Put it there. Let them see it clearly. The one who want to see good days and want to live long, the Bible says that person must keep his tongue from evil, 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 lying, cheating, backbiting people, gossip. Keep your mouth from evil. Keep your mouth from deceit. This is why many people are dying untimely death. Their mouths are everywhere. There are people in prison for the sake of their tongue. That's not where I'm going today. Go ahead. Verse 15. Verse 14. Depart from evil and do good. Seek what? And do what? So peace is not free. Peace, as it were. Look at what the Bible says. You need to seek it. You need to look for it. Bible says, seek ye out of the book of the law and read. For none shall want his meat. Seek ye out of the book of the law and read. Seek. Say, seek ye first the kingdom. Seek. You need to look for. Peace is pursued after. See, the same way you pursue money. That's how the Bible says, pursue peace. Many people are not pursuing peace. That's the reason for the challenge that they are going through. Rather, they are pursuing trouble. Go ahead. Let's see how to pursue peace. Go ahead. Verse 15. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open to their cry. One of the ways to pursue peace here, according to the scripture, is righteousness. Any man, any woman who is not living a righteous life, you are not pursuing peace, you are pursuing trouble. No wonder, trouble everywhere. John chapter 16 verse 33. John 16 33. Jesus said very clear. He said, in the world ye shall have tribulations. He said, these things I have spoken unto you, that ye might have peace. But in the world ye shall have tribulation. But be of good cheer, for I have overcome. In me you will have peace. But in the world, you will have what?
Tribulations.
In the word tribulation means trouble. But in me, he said, come to me and I will give you peace. Matthew 11, from verse 28 to 30. Come to me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. And what will I do? I will give you peace. Any man who is not pursuing righteousness, pursuing after righteousness, is pursuing peace. Every man on earth is pursuing something. It's either you are pursuing peace or you are pursuing trouble. It's either you are pursuing peace or you are pursuing trouble. When you keep men pari passu, two things. Either they are pursuing peace or they are pursuing trouble. Ladies and gentlemen, pursue after righteousness. Isaiah chapter 54 from verse 13 to 14. When you have this peace, the Bible says, in righteousness you will be established. Say, and all thy children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of thy children. Verse 14, in righteousness. In. Look at it. In righteousness. Verse 13 said, your children will have peace. Verse 14 said, in. So for you to have access to peace, you must be what? In righteousness. You must be in. In. If the devil give you peace, he will kill you. The peace from the devil kills, because his peace is momentary. I would say the blessings of the Lord make it rich, and it does not add sorrow. In other words, there are blessings that come from some quarters that comes with sorrow. If you know your Bible well, the blessings of the Lord make it rich, it does not add sorrow. There are blessings from certain quarters that comes with sorrow. They look like blessing, but they are death in disguise. I heard the story of a man who went to do blood money. They gave him the money. The enemy gave him the money and gave him 7 years. Gave him how many years? 7 years. The man made money year 1 year, 2 year, 3 made money. Inside the money, in heart, the beat came. Ladies and gentlemen, when you see people who looks like as if they are wealthy, but they are very stingy, that wealth is questionable. When you see people that looks as if they are wealthy, you see around them, you see one or two rickety and wretched cars. Maybe 2022 model rickety cars. You know, even the cars of 2025 are rickety. The ones that have, they are wretched cars. You know why? Those things are not durable. While we were growing up, ladies and gentlemen, 504 SR. If you had me that time, you were a president, 12 of us. If they dash you now, even your security, you won't give him. Even the farmer in the village, do you know what they do with such cars now? They are dustbin. Almost all the people that owns them now, they are dustbins in their houses. The enemy gave the man money and gave him 7 years. So for the 7 years that this man was making little, little money, oh my God, his heart was in his mouth. No peace. Anybody come to him, oh God, give me 1 naira. Say, do you know how I got my money? Be careful with those people that are always telling you that where they got the money truly is very bad. Do you know how I got my money? If you want, go and get it. They won't give you. That's why you see some people very wealthy, but everybody around them very poor. They can't make anybody rich. You know why? Because they have no peace. That money does not give them peace. It's the one from God that will give peace. It's people that get money from God that can give you. Those that got from the devil. Wasting your time. When the seventh year came, the man went to a pastor for prayer. Pastor said, repent and give your life to Jesus. I return all these things they gave you back to them. You must restitute them. The man said, hi. Since the Baba day inside bush, Baba that is inside bush, that doesn't have a house, wearing kampe, obente. How many of you know obente? One small leaf in the front.
Baba is not rich and Baba wants to make you rich. Are you not afraid? Baba doesn't have a car. He doesn't have an AC. He doesn't know light. And he wants to give you light. It is what you have that you give. He doesn't have peace. There is no man in his senses that have good thing that want to stay inside the bush. Why are they not living in mansions? Have you ever asked yourself, anywhere you go, they put leaf. You see the man paint his face black, white, yellow. Why you paint your face? Look, we know who you are. The foolish man said, well, since Baba didn't say bush, if I fly to America or to London, in Juju no fit cross Mediterranean Sea, come there. Let me go and hide there and enjoy my money. As he was inside the aircraft took off. He died. There is no peace, says the law, unto the wicked. Church, you access durable peace through righteousness. Go ahead, let me read my Bible I was reading before. Durable riches can be accessed through righteousness. Not this one. That's Psalms 34. I was reading verse 15. Psalms 34 from verse 15. Durable riches can be gotten through righteousness. The Bible says, the eyes of the Lord is upon the righteous and his ears are open to their cry. Number two, for you to get this kind of durable riches or durable peace, you must be a prayerful man or woman. You must be what? Ladies and gentlemen, do you know that you can pray peace in? You can pray peace into your life. That's where I will end up now, so that we can pray. You can pray peace into your life. Ah, Jesus. You can pray peace into your life. Psalms 122 verse 6. The Bible says, pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. For they shall prosper that love thee. Pray for the peace. Which means you can ask for peace. Jeremiah 29 and verse 7. Jeremiah 29 and verse 7. He said, pray again for the peace of Jerusalem. Pray. Jeremiah 29 verse 7. 7. Verse 7. Pray for the peace. He said, and seek the peace of the city whither I have caused you to go. Be carried away captive. Pray unto the Lord for it. For in the peace thereof ye shall have peace. Pray for that peace. As you get the peace, in the peace you will have peace. If you stay in an environment of peace, you will have peace. But you need to pray for that peace. You pray for Jerusalem. For in the peace that comes to Jerusalem, you will have peace. Ladies and gentlemen, if Nigeria does not have peace, you don't have peace. If Benue does not have peace, you don't have peace. You need to pray for the peace. Many of you, you watch your parents, you watch your brothers, you watch your sisters every day. Problem, 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 problem. You have refused to pray for peace. So you watch the thing increasing. You are not praying for peace. We are going to pray today. In 1 Samuel, 1 Samuel chapter 1 from verse 6 to 9. Write it down. 1 Samuel chapter 1 from verse 6 to 9. The Bible says, and Penina provoked Hannah. She provoked Hannah to the point that the woman lost her peace. Penina made sure Hannah lost her peace. Hallelujah. Amen. Hannah lost her peace. Now, hear this. When Hannah lost her peace, what did she do? She prayed. Hannah lost her peace. The Bible said from verse 7, immediately the woman knew that her peace was gone. She mobilized herself together and began to pray. She prayed and prayed and prayed and prayed and prayed until we got to verse 15. 1 Samuel 1:15-17. Put it. Let me show you what happened there. And Hannah answered and said, "No, my Lord, I am a woman of a sorrowful spirit. I have lost my peace. I lost it." In case you are here and your case is like Hannah, you have been with a sorrowful spirit, my God is going to give you peace today. I'm a woman, put it on the screen. I'm a woman of a sorrowful spirit. I didn't drink wine. I didn't do anything, okay? It's just that I have lost my peace. I lost it. Verse 16 and 17, let me close there. Count not the handmaid to be a daughter of Belial, for out of the abundance of my complaint and grief have I spoken. You see, she lost her peace totally. It was somebody that provoked her. So there are trouble provokers. There are men and women sent by the devil to ensure that you lose your peace. But hear me, my God will reply them for you today. Look at verse 17. I love this. And Eli answered and said unto her, "Go what? Go what? Go what? What she lost." Eli knew that what Hannah lost was her peace. If only the peace can come back, everything she's asking for, she can get it. If the peace can come back, then you can get back whatever you're asking for. So Eli replied, he said, "Woman, don't go in sorrowful spirit. Go in what? Go in what? Go in what? Go in what?" Somebody is living here this morning with the peace of God in the name of Jesus. I don't know how long you have been praying.
Yes.
I don't know how long you have been of a sorrowful spirit. You have been in grief. You have been in torment. But this morning, you will be living here in peace in the name of Jesus. Eli only prophesied peace to Hannah.
Yes.
Eli prophesied peace. Say, "Woman, go in peace. Woman, go in peace. Woman, go in peace. Woman, go in peace." Somebody is living here today with the peace of God flowing in your spirit in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Go in peace. So you discover that the problem of Hannah was the problem of lack of peace. We thought the problem was because she had no child. No. The reason why the children were not coming was because the woman had no peace. Many of you, you are in church. You have been praying for a particular thing. The thing didn't come. It's because you lack peace. If peace is not in place, prayers can never be answered. Can I preach on? I don't want to enter what I want to teach during the second service. Because in Philippians chapter 4, from verse 6, the Bible says, "Be anxious for nothing, but in everything, with prayer and supplication, coupled with thanksgiving, let your requests be known." What does it mean not to be anxious? But I will be at peace. If you are not at peace, prayers are always a struggle. You don't get answered to your prayers. No matter how you pray, if you are in trouble, if your spirit is not at rest, you don't get answered to your prayers. That's why Paul said he gave them the keys. And we talk about that during second service. He gave them the keys to accessing answer prayer. And one of them is to be at peace. When you are at peace, you pray, you get answer. That's why Eli said to Hannah, "Say, woman, go in peace." Then he said, "The Lord grant unto thee according to thy petition." Before you can get your petition answered, you must be in peace.
I prophesy.
Every peace that you have lost. Is it peace in your family? Is it peace in your ministry? Is it peace in your business?
Yes.
In the name that is above every other name, my God is restoring them back.
Amen.
I said you are getting them back in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Stand up on your feet. Let us pray for peace.
Yes.
Let us pray for peace. Lift up your right hand to heaven. Say, my Father.
My Father.
My Father.
My Father.
My Father.
My Father.
Give me peace.
Give me peace
of my heart.
Peace of my heart.
Give me peace.
Give me peace.
Every peace that I have lost, restore them back today. Somebody lift up your voice and begin to pray. Now pray for peace. Pray like never before. Let there be peace in your life. Let there be peace in your family. Father, give me peace. Lord, give me peace. Lord, give me peace. Lord, give me peace. I ask for peace in my family. I ask for peace in my business. I ask for peace in everything I do. I ask for peace. Lord, give me peace. Somebody lift up your voice and pray. Lord, give me peace.
Father, give me peace.
In the blessed Lord,
saving me.
In Jesus' name of prayer.
Amen.
And amen. I decree peace upon you.
Amen.
I said I decree peace upon you.
Amen.
The Bible says I should prophesy peace. Am I correct?
Yes.
Jeremiah 28 and verse 9. 28 and verse 9. Say the prophet that prophesied peace. I prophesy peace upon your life.
Amen.
Peace in your business. Peace in your ministry. Peace in your family. Peace in every area of your life. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Take your seat very quickly. Pick up your offerings. Quickly. Pick up your offerings. Pick up your tithes. If you are a tither, run to the altar. Let me pray for you. Quickly. If you are a tither and you are in the church, carry it in your hands. Come to the altar. Let me pray for you. And if you are here, maybe you didn't come to church with your offering, or you didn't come with your tithe. This is very important. You didn't come to church with your offering or your tithe. Pick up the church account number from the screen. In front of you, look at the church account number there. Write it down yourself. Transfer that offering, that your sacrifice to that church account. The Almighty God will reward you as you do that and bless you in Jesus' name. Father, please accept these offerings, these tithes from the hands of your children. As they drop it on your altar, let their heavens be open. Financial heaven be open. And the peace of God come upon them in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Drop it on the altar. Church, lift up your offerings, everyone. Lift it up. Father, accept these offerings from our hands. Let these offerings come up to you as a sweet smelling savour. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Stand up on your feet quickly. Stand up on your feet, everyone. Come to the altar with your offering. Come and drop it on the altar, everyone. Oh, Daddy, we love you. While you are dropping the offering, listen to this announcement very quickly. Listen. Listen. The 1st of December is on Tuesday. The 1st of December is on Tuesday. Tuesday, 1st. Wednesday, 2nd. Thursday, 3rd. Those 3 days this week. From Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we have entered the month of December already. So we are going to be having a 3 days program from Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, titled "I Must Fulfill the Prophecy of the Year." I must fulfill the prophecy of the year. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I must fulfill the prophecy of the year. Ladies and gentlemen, we have entered the last month of the year. So Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday is 5 p.m. in the evening. Now, don't just clap. Go and tell every man. Tell every man, every woman you know, that Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday is a program in your church, 5 p.m. each day. I must, not I will. I will show you what it takes to fulfill prophecy. We will take it by fire. This year will not end until I am honored. Your amen is very weak, church, if you are there. So tell them, Tuesday, Thursday, and Wednesday, 5 p.m. each day, is a special program. Please invite your friends. Use your mouth. Use every resources you have to get people to church. It's a combined service. All our branches worldwide, they will be here. The last lap of the year, the last days is everybody's days. It's your own day. In Jesus' mighty name. So please invite your friends. Invite your well-wishers for that service. And don't forget, this week Saturday, there's going to be home cell at 5 p.m. in all our cell centers. And next Sunday service is the first Sunday in the month of December. It's going to be our prophetic service. First service, 7 a.m. Second service is 9 a.m. in the morning. Church, clap hands for Jesus. This is a good news for everyone. On the 13th of December is our end of the year Thanksgiving service. All families, all units, and every individual that you know and you know, God have blessed you. Start preparing for that Thanksgiving, 13th of December by 8 a.m. in the morning. Invite your friends and bring them. God bless you. Men of honor, you are having your meeting today by 4 p.m. Men of honor, your meeting is today by 4 p.m. 4 p.m. Please ensure you are there. Hallelujah. Old members and new members, you all are welcome. And there's going to be a brief. Okay. Please, all the leaders of the home cell, all the leaders of the home cell, submit your report for your home cell of yesterday. Submit it to the coordinators, Pastor Haruna, Evangelist Agada, and Pastor Abraham. God bless you. There's going to be a brief meeting of the security after second service. After second service. New members are welcome to the security department. Hallelujah. Now, this is another good news for somebody. This is a good news. This is a good news. Today, our reality theater, that's the drama arm of the church, They shot a world-class film. And today, they are going to be premiering the film right here in the church. If we say we'll give them opportunity now, that film is like 30, 45 minutes. They are going to be shooting the film on the screen so that the church will be the first to watch it before they start selling outside. Because it's a sellable film. It's a marketable film all over the world. You'll be surprised to know the kind of talent that you have in the church. So please, today, by 3:30 p.m., 3:30 this afternoon, just come and sit down. Let the drama show you what they have. The film they shot, everything was done in Makurdi, using everything available in the church, but within Makurdi town. You won't believe it. It's a world-class film. I'm sure many of you, if you see it, you want to market it. So please, by 3:30 p.m., ensure you just go back home, invite your friends, let them come and watch. Let them come and watch the Christian movie. And God will bless you as you do that in Jesus' name. By next week Sunday in the evening by 3 p.m., our sister, our pastor, Sister Patience, Evangelist Patience, should be having a music program in a church called Champions Power Assembly at Wurukum. At Wurukum, next week we'll be giving you the vivid description, and the time is 2:30 p.m. in the afternoon. Now, the books are there with the ushers. Get the books from the ushers. Get the books, and God will bless you as you do that. Please don't go without getting a book before you go. And I see God blessing you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Today is our Thanksgiving service. And I'm sure you know, and we all are prepared for that. Carry a seed in your hand, a sacrificial seed in your hands. Carry a sacrificial seed, and we will all go behind. The choir will sing, we'll dance to the altar in the next few minutes, and then we'll take our Thanksgiving. Everyone, you know God has been good to you. This is more than offering. Carry a Thanksgiving sacrificial seed in your hand to say, Father, thank you for what you did for me in the month of November. Carry the Thanksgiving seed and move behind right now as we quickly do that. God bless you.
I just want to say, Jesus, thank you. You do me well, Lord.
I just want to say, Jesus, thank you. You do me well, Lord.
I just want to say, Jesus, thank you. You do me well, Lord.
I just want to say, Jesus, thank you. You do me well, Lord.
I just want to say, Jesus, thank you. You do me well, Lord.
I just want to say, Jesus, thank you. You do me well, Lord.
I just want to say, Jesus, thank you. You do me well, Lord.
I just want to say, Jesus, thank you. You do me well,
Papa, you do me well, Lord.
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 Jesus, you do me well, Lord.
You do me well, Lord.
Father, you do me well, Lord.
You do me well, Lord.
Jesus, you do me well, Lord.
You do me well, Lord.
Papa, you do me well, Lord.
Papa, you do me well, Lord.
I just wanna say, Jesus, thank you. You do me well, oh.
Hey, my God is good, oh.
Hey, my God is good, oh.
Everyone who have come to give you thanks. In
in the days of trouble, remember the thanksgiving and deliver your children. In Jesus' name we pray. If this is your first Sunday of coming to this church, can we see your hands up? We love you. You're welcome. If this is your first Sunday, you have never been here before, this is your first Sunday, wow, you're welcome, sir. Stand up on your feet. Just come to the altar. Stand up on your feet. Come to the altar very quickly. We love you. You are welcome. We love you, sir. We love you. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. The Lord bless you, sir. The Lord bless you. Church, I decree and declare you blessed in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. As you depart from here, the peace of God that surpasses every human understanding, that peace goes with you in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
You will never lack peace in your life.
Amen.
And your enemies who don't want you to have peace, they will know no peace.
Amen.
Their own peace will flow to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are blessed.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
And amen. Church, surely
God's goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever.